So we wanted to show you how the framework works in action. And here we are in my school today. I teach in a rural school in County Limerick, a four-teacher school. We're going to bring you through all the different classes to show you how the framework is working in all of them.
Who's going to mind the balloon?
We use the framework to engage the children. So here, the infants teacher has used a balloon.
Did they get bigger?
Yeah.
By using a balloon, the teacher can inflate the balloon, which will expand the fingerprint, allowing it easier for the younger children to see. Other children are also exploring fingerprints using Play-Doh.
Bit of a problem when I came in this morning. What was in here yesterday when we left?
Jellies.
What's not in it this morning?
Jellies.
Bit of a crime to solve, guys.
In third and fourth class, we are using the stolen jellies to begin the discussion on fingerprints.
So we have to figure out what is the best way to solve this crime.
By the fingerprint.
The fingerprints. Good girl. What do we know about fingerprints?
We know that everyone has different fingerprints.
Very good. So what else can you tell me about fingerprints?
Using the stolen jellies will help to elicit prior knowledge from the children before we begin any investigation. It also encourages them to begin wondering and thinking about fingerprints.
Then you put your tongue down on it, and then you take out sellotape.
The next step is investigation. Here, the children in 5th and 6th class are using the magnifying glasses to identify the type of fingerprints. Children are working in pairs to encourage collaborative work.
Yeah, I think it's nice.
Mine is an loop.
Oh, that one. That one's the mystery pin. That's the mystery one.
Also, children in the ASD class are looking at their fingerprints. Enlarging the images will engage and support these pupils.
Which one of them stole the jellies? I'm not sure. Could you both hold up your fingers?
The last step is we're extending the knowledge of fingerprints in first and second with our identical twin boys.
Now they have a number.
The children are exploring if the identical twins have the same fingerprints and are looking to identify who owns which fingerprint.
Look in here, tell the difference between the two sets of fingerprints.
One's more a bit rounder.
Rounder, exactly. The circles start here. So if you look at your own fingerprints.
And lastly, it's back to the mystery of the stolen jellies, as the children have their own fingerprints ready for examination.
So you put your thumb on the paper.
Now, the next step for them is to try and lift some prints from the jar to find the real culprit.
And who's 7?
As part of the reflection, the children discuss what has worked well today in the science lesson and what they will need to do the next time. Reflection is key for teachers and pupils. As a teacher, I always keep note of what's working well and what I need to be aware of for the next science lesson, as no two science lessons are the same.
See, I think we'll have to fingerprint some of the staff today to see can we figure it out, will we?
Yeah. Definitely.
So I hope that gives you an insight of how the framework works across all classes and how it can be adapted for any class in a primary school.